Organizing and displaying quantitative data. Quantitative data can be organized into frequency distribution and can be displayed by using histogram, frequency polygon, and/or GIF. Consider this example. 50 students were asked about number of hours they spend playing computer games per week. The data obtained is a quantitative raw data. Quantitative raw data can be simplified and organized into a table that lists the values in the data that have been grouped into range or classes in one column and number of occurrence or frequency of each class in another column. This table is called frequency distribution of quantitative data. From this frequency distribution, we can draw a histogram, a frequency polygon, and an OR GIF. Let's look at how to draw a histogram. To draw a histogram, we must first find class boundary for each class. Each class has two boundaries called lower boundary and upper boundary. Lower boundary of a class is found by adding the upper limit of the previous class to the lower limit of that particular class and dividing it by 2. Upper boundary of a class is found by adding the upper limit of that particular class to the lower limit of the next class and dividing it by 2. This is how we find class boundary. After the class boundaries are found, plot the class boundary on the horizontal axis and the frequency on the vertical axis, and then draw a bar for each class with the height corresponding to their frequency. Note that for a histogram, the bars must be close to each other. Lastly, write the title of the histogram. Now let's look at how to draw a frequency polygon. To draw a frequency polygon, we must first find midpoint for each class. Midpoint of a class is found by taking the summation of the lower limit and the upper limit of that particular class and dividing it by 2. This is how we find midpoint. After midpoints are found, plot the midpoint on the horizontal axis and the frequency on the vertical axis, and then plot a dot for each midpoint at the height corresponding to their frequency. Also, add one midpoint for the class before the first class and one midpoint for the class after the last class, and plot a dot at frequency 0 for both midpoints. Connect the dots with straight lines. Lastly, write the title of the frequency polygon. Now let's look at how to draw an OR GIF. To draw an OR GIF, we must first find cumulative frequency for each class. Cumulative frequency for the first class is simply the frequency of the class itself. Cumulative frequency of the next class is found by adding the cumulative frequency of the previous class to the frequency of that particular class. This is how we find cumulative frequency. After cumulative frequencies are found, plot class boundary on the horizontal axis and the cumulative frequency on the vertical axis, and then plot a dot for each class boundary at the height corresponding to their cumulative frequency. Note that the first class boundary has zero cumulative frequency. Connect the dots with straight lines. Lastly, write the title of the OR GIF.